Hello Storyboarders, my name is Eric, and today I'm going to make a wanted poster using one of Storyboard That's pre-made templates. So let's get started. First, I'm going to select a poster that I like this one. So just click the copy template button that is found directly below. And this will bring us straight into the Storyboard Creator, which will then prompt us to give our poster a name. So you can name it whatever you would like. I'm just going to call it Poster 1 and click Continue. All right, now it's time for us to customize our poster. This is where we get to add any characters, items, update text, whatever changes we want to make. So first, I would like to replace this character with a new one. We have a nice silhouette and a placeholder right here. So all we have to do is delete this one and add our own character. Go up to the characters menu, and I would like to add a pirate. So I'm going to search in the 16 to 1800s category. Let's find a pirate. Here we go. Just drag and drop your character into your poster. And now we get to customize our character. This is where we get to add facial expressions, poses, make any other changes that we want to. Now, when your character is all set, just click Update Pose, and there we go. Now, you can move your character anywhere you want in your poster. You can also resize them. Just drag the corner of the image, and there we go. So let's put this pirate right about here. And they are a little bit outside this box, so let's crop them. You can select crop in the right-hand menu. And let's pull this box up. And we can see through the transparency the picture box, which lets us know what we need to line this up with. Then click OK. All right, perfect. Now next is items. You can browse the items category to find whatever item you would like, or you can search for something in the upper right-hand search menu. I feel like this pirate needs a sword, so let's search sword and pick out one that we like. All right, this looks pretty good. Let's just drag and drop. Now that is a little too small, so let's make it bigger. That's a good size. And reposition it. Now it does feel a little weird with how they're holding it, so let's rotate the sword. Now you can rotate items by grabbing the top center button and dragging and turning. And reposition. There we go. All right, now I would like my pirate to be holding a parrot. So if you go back to the characters menu and go all the way to the right to the animals category, we can search for a parrot. Now you can scroll through all of the animals, or you can go to the filters and select birds. This will narrow our search down. All right, here we go, a red macaw. So let's drag down this big parrot and let's go to rotate and flip. And let's make them a little bit bigger. Macaws are very big birds. And now the pirate is in the pirate's hand. All right, perfect. Now let's zoom out. Now next is backgrounds. Now you can select the item and change the color to whatever you would like. But I would like something a bit more fun. So let's delete this pre-existing design and select a new one. So if we go up to our scenes menu, I'm going to go over to the patterns category. And I'm going to pick out a wood grain. All right, this is perfect. Let's just drag and drop this into our poster and stretch to fill. Let's go with non-proportional so we can see all those wood grains and then click OK. Now, once you have your scene in place, send it to the back of the poster. That looks good. It's a little too dark and it's making the rest of this wanted text hard to read. So let's change the color. You can change the colors in the right-hand menu. That looks good, but it still feels a little bright. I think I want to make it a sepia tone. Now, if you go over to your filters in the right-hand menu, you can select all of these different options. I'm going to go with sepia tone to give it an old-timey feel. Then click OK. All right, perfect. Now, I would like a scene behind our pirate as well. So, let's search historical. I think we can find a nice boat for them. Here we go. Just drag and drop. And since we want this to go into the specific box, we're going to stretch to fill. So let's line it up, drag this bottom corner till we fill up the whole space. Perfect. And let's crop. Drag the side, line it up with the transparency image behind us, and then click OK. Now we can't see anybody, so we have to send this back. So let's send it one item at a time. And there we go. Now, it does feel a little strange that this picture is in color, so let's change it to sepia tone as well. In filters, let's click sepia and OK. All right, that looks great. Now, last but not least is text. Now you can edit any of the pre-existing text boxes. All you have to do is click on the item and highlight what you want to change. Now, I like the title just being wanted, but I want a different font. So let's go to the text editor and select a new font. That's good. And let's make that really big. Let's go with font size 200. All right, perfect. Now you can also add in any of your own words. So let's change this reward to nothing to $1 million. So let's start a new line. All right, now let's make this the same font as the wanted title. Go to our text editor, select the font, and I want the $1 million just to be larger. So I'm gonna highlight just the million, and let's double that font size. So let's go to 120, great. Now I want it really spread out so it draws a lot of attention. So let's put a space between each individual letter. Perfect. Now I still have a little bit of space here. Now maybe putting in a dollar sign or like a money bag would work. Now you can search for that in the upper right hand search menu, or you can look for an icon in the icon, the infographics category. So let's go to icons and let's drag this over. Ah, perfect. A nice bag with money sign on it. Just drag and drop it into your poster. Let's stretch it to be a little bit larger. And let's change the color. All right, perfect. Now let's copy this so we have one on the other side. And put it right here. All right, perfect. Now, when you're all done making the changes to your wanted poster, all you have to do is click the orange Save and Exit button in the bottom right-hand corner. And that is how you make a wanted poster using Storyboard That. Thanks for watching, and happy storyboarding.